Hello, you are probably watching this video because you have been diagnosed with a salivary gland stone. You may be hearing about this for the first time because its rate is nearly 7 out of 10,000 in the population. However, I see patients on this issue every day and I have been working for 19 years. To relieve your concerns, I'll show you my intervention in a typical case. The patient here is a 38 years old woman. For 3 years, there has been swelling under her right chin, especially when eating. Swelling has become more frequent lately, and 1 month ago, she had a severe inflammation. She went to a clinic and a tomography scan was taken. Inside her submandibular gland, a salivary gland stone with a diameter approximately 8 millimeters was detected. Then she was recommended to have a submandibular gland resection, that is, to remove the salivary gland with an open surgery. She did not want to lose her gland and take the risks of open surgery, so she wanted me to help her with sialendoscopic approach. Let's look at her tomography. You can see the stone in white color medially to right jawbone, blinking. This is the 3D tomography image. It's obvious how deep the stone located in hilum. And this is the operation video. The stone was stuck 6 cm deep from the ductal orifice. I am making shots to the stone with a metal probe. As you can see, the stone begins to fall into pieces. I'll show you faster because this is actually a 2-hour work, but don't worry, you will still be able to understand it easily. Here I show mostly fragmentation. In fact, I also clean the stone pieces. I'm not showing these to avoid making the video longer. Let me give you some technical information. The diameter of the salivary duct is about 2 mm. The diameter of my sialendoscope is 1.6 mm and my fragmenting probe is 0.6 mm. Actually, current treatment algorithm for this kind of stone says intraoral surgery or gland removal. I started sialendoscopy in 2004. I have been removing large stones this way since 2007. Since the fragmentation is pneumatically, air pressure does not cause heat damage. It may seem so easy to you watching here, but in fact, we Turks have a saying, to dig a well with a needle. This is it. It requires years of training, lithotripsy equipment, advanced sialendoscopy experience, and most importantly, determination and patience. This is the last big piece of the stone. I'm fragmenting it too. Fragments need to be small enough. I will also show you how I collect them. I remove the last pieces with this tool we call forceps. Let me show you the radiologic image of the stone again. Pay attention to its location and size. I made over 400 pneumatic shots to this stone and removed all the pieces out of the submandibular gland in 2 hours. This is just an example. I will show more difficult cases when I have time. My colleagues who want medical information about this technique can look at my last publication in 2022, which includes data on 111 stones. They can also benefit from my other past works and the book, but in Turkish, I wrote in 2008. Patients who are curious can follow my other videos and web pages in public language. Thanks for watching.